So, good morning everyone. Today I will present about writing a narrative essay. So as we learn that the outline of this presentation is definition of narrative essay, characteristic of a narrative essay, structure of story, and then narrative essay organization, steps for writing a narrative essay, and writing notes. Okay, let's continue to the definition of narrative essay. But before that, we have to know about what is narrative essay, atau what is narrative. So actually, narrative is another word for story. Narrative essay tells a story, and then narrative essays present a series of events in order to inform or entertain the audience. Even though the narrative essay has the same basic form as most other academic essays, it allows the writer to be a little more creative than academic essays usually do. There are some characteristics of a narrative essay. The first is the purpose of narrative essay is to inform or tell a story, and then information is presented in a chronological order. And then the next characteristic is the writer is a storyteller. And then written in the first person voice, usually using I, somewhat informal. And then the next characteristic, describe a person, scene, or event in detail, or emphasize on showing rather than telling. And the last characteristic is can include dialogue. This is the structure of a story. So, the first is setting. The setting is the location where the action in a story takes place. And then theme. The theme is the basic idea of the story. Very often the theme will deal with a topic that is common in life or human nature, such as independence and why, courage, valor, and success. Then the next structure is mood. The mood is the feeling or atmosphere that the writer creates for the story. It could be happy, hopeful, suspenseful, or scary. Both the setting and descriptive vocabulary create the mood in a narrative. And then the next structure is characters. The characters are the people in the story. They are affected by the mood of the story and they react to the events in which they are involved. And the last is plot. The plot is what happens in the story, that is the sequence of events. The plot often includes a climax or turning point at which the characters or events change. This is the narrative essay organization. So, narrative essay organization has three main parts. The first one is introduction. The second part is body paragraphs. And the last part is conclusion. Introduction consists of hook. So, the hook gets the reader's attention with an interesting or surprising fact, and then background. The background tells the story, the history, or what happened before the action. And thesis. The thesis sentence prepares the readers for the main action of the story, but it doesn't tell the whole story or just a hint about the main action. For the body paragraphs, it usually tells the main story. They use a lot of details to bring the story to life. And it consists of situation, rising action, and climax. And then for the conclusion, It tells about what happened after the main event, about a lesson the writer learned, and how the writer's life is changed now. So for the activity, try to identify part of narrative essay. Okay, anyone can help me to answer the question number 1 up to 7? What is the definition of hook? Hook is, so which one belongs to hook? Have you done it, activity 1? Ada yang sudah mengerjakan? Okay, Pascal, maybe?
Hook, CMM, Japan is known as land of the rising sun.
Okay, hook. So hook, yang masuk hook ya, belongs to hook is sea. Japan is known as land of the rising sun. Okay, how about the background? Firda, maybe? The sentence that belongs to background mana?
I think the D, ma'am. When I was young, I always thought Japan was an exotic country with interesting customs. I always wanted to go to Japan.
Yeah, okay, D ya. Okay, now how about the thesis sentence? Chosi? Okay, number 3, Chosi Manggana.
I think it's E. I didn't know that I was going to learn an important lesson because of a simple pastry.
Yeah, okay. So this is sentence-nya. This is the writer feel, yeah, or the writer opinion. Okay, how about the situation number 4? Ni Putu ada?
Ada, ma'am.
Yes.
I think it's E, ma'am.
Your situation E.
Yes, ma'am.
How about the thesis sentence? I learned that many things in Japan look the same. Yang A, ya, mungkin.
Yeah, I think okay. It's B, ma'am.
Yes?
Yang B. That's the sentence, yang B. Getting off the airplane and walking the streets of Tokyo, Japan was very exciting, but it also felt like home.
Okay. Yeah, okay. So, yang thesis sentence B, and then the situation E. Okay, now number 5. Fepta Ninda ada?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
Rising action, yang mana? Which one do you think?
I think it's F. I wanted something to eat. I found a bakery and I saw a strawberry jam pastry.
Okay, how about the climax?
Climax, I think is G. Finally, bit into the pastry and I was shocked to find it was not strawberry.
Yeah, okay. And then conclusionnya, K berarti ya. I learned that many things in Japan look the same ya, as in the UK, but they are truly Japanese. And we should appreciate them. Now traveling is more enjoyable ya. Okay. Next, tolong dibaca activity 2, reading students essay. Igusti Ayu Made ada? The first paragraph.
Ada, ma'am.
Ya, silakan.
My first foreign friend broke my heart. However, before I could have a foreign friend, I needed to travel abroad first. I have always wanted to go abroad and make friends around the world. Last winter, I was able to study abroad for 4 weeks in Toronto. While I was studying in Toronto, I met a Canadian girl named Jen. She told me that she wanted to make Japanese friends. So I was happy to talk to her. I was also happy to talk to her because she is so beautiful. Jen is half white and half Filipino, and I had never seen anyone like her before. It is safe to say that I fell in love with her at the first sight, but not everything is meant to be.
Okay, paragraph 2. Firda Dwi.
In the beginning of our friendship, I was able to meet Jem often because we were language exchange partners. Jem helped me study English, and I helped her study Japanese. Gradually, we became more and more friendly. So I invited her to go out to eat dinner with me. We went to a restaurant with her friends who also study Japanese. I talked a lot with her and her friends in English, and we ate katsudon. It is very delicious. Having dinner together made me very happy, and I think that my language skill improved.
Okay, next, Bayu Kotama, ada? Next paragraph. Yes. Bayu?
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. One day?
Mm-hmm. One day, I went to watch an American football game with my Kwansei Gakuan friends. At the game, I saw Jim with another student. I said hello, and I asked about her friend. She said, he is my boyfriend. That is, she had a boyfriend. I was surprised, and I was disappointed in love. Furthermore, her boyfriend was also Japanese, and I was studying abroad like me. I was sad because of that unbelievable fact. At that moment, I thought that my experience in other country was sad.
Yeah, okay, next, Pascal.
At last, the day I went back to Japan, I heard from Jen by email. In her email, she wrote, thank you for being my friend. I want to meet you and speak in Japanese when I go to Japan in December. Her email really made me smile. I forgot about my feelings at the football game and remember all the great times I had in Toronto. Overall, I learned that life is made up of good and bad memories, but it is most important to remember the good ones.
Yeah, okay, so this is the story of students' essay, yeah? Okay, now, for number one, why is the background information in the introduction important to the story? Kira-kira ada yang bisa menjawab? What do you think? Alfira? Based on your opinion. Kira-kira why is the background information in the introduction important to the story? Ada yang have an idea to answer the question? I will continue the questions. So I read all of the questions, then after that we can answer based on the story. Yeah. So number two, how did the writer and Jim become friends? And what is the situation? And number three, what happened before the writer's heart was broken? What is the rising action? And the fourth question, what broke the writer's heart? And what is the climax of the story? And the last question is, what did the writer learn? And was it a positive lesson for negative lesson. Okay, I will continue the slide. So actually, there are 6 steps for writing a narrative essay. Step 1, organizing your thoughts or brainstorming. The second step, researching your topic. And then step 3, developing a thesis statement. Step 4, writing the introduction. Step 5, writing the body of the essay. And step 6, writing the conclusion. Okay, for the first step, organizing your thoughts, or we call it brainstorming, we have free writing, so you can write quickly without stopping. Editing or self-correcting to become aware of what you already know, think or feel on a topic. And then you can use WH questions. So ask the question who, what, when, where, why, and in some cases, how. The answers to these questions will help clarify what you would like to write about. So you can make subject 3 related ideas, connecting outwards from the main topic in a 3 form. And then you can make lists, free flow of ideas on a topic. So in brainstorming, you can use subject 3, lists, or you can make clustering. So the main topic is in the middle circle. All related associations are linked to the main topic. And the last brainstorming type is outline. So you can make framework of an essay, which includes main points followed by the breakdown into sub points. For the step 2, researching your topic, actually narrative essays are unique in that research is conducted within the scope of your personal life and experiences. This means that research may consist of personal artifacts, and then memorabilia, and then anecdotes and conversations. For step 3, we can develop a thesis statement. So to create a thesis statement, combine the claim and the supporting details in a 1 sentence. And the direction of your essay can change depending on the pattern in which you organize the supporting details. For example, supporting details organized into categories. For example, laughter has always been an important part of my family. It has helped us to get comfortable after long separations, made it easier to deal with difficult times, and serve as a form of entertainment. This is if we want to use supporting details into categories. If we use supporting details organized into time frames, the example is, laughter has always been an important part of my life, supporting me throughout my childhood, teenage years, and my adult life. So actually, writing is a fluid process. As you complete your essay, you may realize that your thesis needs to be modified to reflect your position better. And then step 4, writing the introduction. So the introduction is the most general part of the paper. It helps provide a roadmap for further discussion or analysis. This simplified formula offers components for a basic introduction. Hook. So hook means get the reader's attention with an interesting or surprising facts. Background, tell the history, what had happened before the action, and show the importance of your topic, concept, or theme. And thesis. It means that you have to prepare the readers for the main action of the story. Okay, let's see about the hook. The hook is the first sentence of your essay, And the purpose of a hook is to get reader's attention. There are five types of hooks. The first is shocking statement. The second one, interesting facts. And then next type is statistic. And then the fourth, questions. The fifth, quote. And the sixth, sound effects. Okay, now try to identifying hook. So you can read the paragraph and then underline the hook. Okay, let's get start with okay, who wants to try to read? Riris, ada?
Ada, ma'am.
Yes, silakan dibaca.
I cannot live without pizza if I go very long without eating a hot delicious slice of pizza. I become sick. When I live in the United States, I ate a whole pizza every week. But when I started living in Japan, I forgot about eating pizza. I was happy eating delicious Japanese food at first. But I eventually began to crave a hot slice of bread, sauce, and cheese. After living in Japan for 6 months, I ordered Japanese pizza for the first time.
Yeah. Okay, now for number one, what type of hook do you think is used? Kalau kita lihat di previous slide, so there are five types of hook. So which one do you think suitable with this paragraph? Shocking statement, interesting fact, or apa misalnya? So the hook. Dias, maybe can you answer the first question? I cannot live without pizza. This is the hook, right? So it is belongs to which type? Shocking statement atau interesting fact? Yes. What do you think? Interesting statement. Interesting fact. Atau shocking statement, ya. Yeah? Okay, now why do you think a good hook is important? Ada yang bisa menjawab? Rosita, maybe?
I think is to start the paragraph to get interesting of the readers.
Yeah,
interest of readers.
Yeah, so good hook will make the readers are interested in reading your writing, right? Okay, next. Okay, I will skip it. Activity 4 and activity 5. So we go to the thesis. So in a narrative essay, the thesis introduces the action that begins in the first paragraph of the essay. So you can look at these examples of thesis statements. First is, now as I watched the bus driver set my luggage on the airport sidewalk, I realized that my frustration had only just begun. And then the second example, I wanted my mother to watch me race down the step hill. So I called out her name and then knocked my bike forward. And the last statement, because his pride would not allow him to apologize, Ken now had to fight the bully. And he was pretty sure that he would not win. So actually, these thesis statements do not tell the reader what happens. They only introduce the action that will follow. So the paragraphs in the body will develop the story. So this is how to make some thesis statements. And step five, writing the body of the essay. So the body of the essay is the most detailed part. It involves addressing its supporting detail in a spirit fully developed paragraph. And make sure to include the necessary details, illustrations, and examples to support the claims. So actually, there are some elements in narrative. The first is situation, describes when, where, what happens in the story, and then rising action. It means the main events leading to the climax. It uses time order and many details. And the last element is climax. So climax means the main action, the surprise, or the head of the action. For the step six, you can write the conclusion. So conclusion brings the paper to a close. It should be similar to the introduction, but worded differently. It allows you to reiterate and summarize the main points of the essay. Actually, there are some following components comprise a conclusion. So the first is relevance. It means what happened after the main event or why was this important to write about. And then the second component is review, what the writer learned and what main points did you discuss. And the last component is summary. So it means how the writers leave chain now and or what do you claim and conclude. This is some example of relevance. The first example is many families use laughter as a source of joy and healing. This is the example of relevance. And then the example of review, laughter has helped my family unite after prolonged separations, made painful times easier to endure and offered good times. And the example of summary, laughter has and continues to be the balancing force of my family. Okay, we can write some notes. So organization. Narrative essay should begin with an introductory paragraph, which will set up the background of the event, followed by three body paragraphs. And then focus on describing and explaining one point throughout the essay, and the essay with a strong and memorable concluding paragraph. And then know your purpose. So you have to know the purpose of your narrative should be clear to the reader. Knowing your purpose will help you select the details, information, and language best suited to meet your reader's need. And are you writing to entertain or to inform? You have to make the purpose and identify your purpose, whether you want to entertain or to inform. And then narrative should be written based on personal experience because it is difficult to write about something you've never seen or done or read about. So you have to read and write about your personal experience. Don't forget to use capitalize in the beginning of sentences and proper nouns. And then you have to be aware with punctuate, so you can use and marks, for example, question mark, period, or exclamation marks, and commas when joining two sentences with a conjunction addressing a person with quotation and etc. Keep the story moving quickly enough to hold the reader's attention and interest, and then use transitional devices to move the readers from one action to another. Do not rely continuously on the and then method. So you can use many kind of transitional devices, such as, for example, we can use furthermore or next and then and so on. Yeah. And then you can vary your sentences by using short and long sentences. And don't forget use a little figurative language to add interest to your story. For example, we can use similar metaphor or onomatopoeia. And then for notes, yeah, catatan, show and don't tell. So the writer is able to create a picture in the reader's mind. For example, Susan exercised. Can you describe how to exercise? So actually, sweat poured from Susan's forehead as they continued to do 100 sit-ups. So exercised relate to sweat. And then use rich words. Use words that describe the action. For example, my brother goes to school. It can be used another sentence by saying or writing, my brother races to school. And then Sarah said she had a secret. And it is better if we write Sarah whispered to Jamie a wonderful secret. So actually, write from the first person or third person point of view. Most narrative essays are written in the first person, I, but they can also be written in the third person, he, she, or it. If you were part of the action, writing in the first person provides the best perspective. And then if you are relating an event based on information from other sources, write in the third person. Decide on the point of view and be consistent. And then the next note, follow a logical time sequence by using chronological order. You can include flashback technique and use correct tenses or transitional phrases to signal the shift in the time or events to avoid confusion. And then use dialogue realistically. So dialogues create emphasis and drama. By presenting conversation, writers show rather than tell, often creating emphasis or more dramatic effect and creates a feeling or closeness between readers and characters. So this is the example of personal narrative essay. Okay, so I will stop share the slide. Okay, now group three, are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you can start to present. Who will be the host?
I will be the host, ma'am. Afika.
Afika, yeah. Okay, next. Ya, silakan. Oh, Afika ya. Mungkin
iya, Ma.
Rosita, can you give Afika